Before describing the technical requirements for virtualization, let's take a look at the two main virtualization models. The two popular models for virtualization are called bare metal or hypervisor-based and hosted. They're also often referred to as type 1 for the hypervisor-based model and type 2 for the hosted model for virtualization solutions. The bare metal model is like what we illustrated before. A virtual machine monitor or a hypervisor is responsible for the management of the physical resources, and it supports execution of entire virtual machines only. One issue with this model are devices. According to the model, the hypervisor must manage all possible devices, or stated differently, device manufacturers now have to provide device drivers not just for the different operating systems, but also for the different hypervisors that are out there. To eliminate this, the hypervisor model typically integrates a special virtual machine, like a service VM, that runs a standard operating system and has full hardware privileges to access and perform any kind of hardware manipulation, just like if it ran natively on the hardware. It is this privileged VM then that would run all of the device drivers and would have control over how the devices on the platform are used. The service VM also runs some other management tasks and configuration tasks that specifies exactly how the hypervisor would share the resources across the guest VMs, for instance. This model is adapted by the Xen virtualization solution and also by the VMware's hypervisor, the ESX hypervisor. Regarding Xen, both when it comes to the open source version, as well as the version that's supported by Citrix, the Xen server, the VMs that run in the virtualized environment are referred to as domains. The privileged domain is called DOM0, and the guest VMs are referred to as DOMUs. Xen is the actual hypervisor, and all of the drivers are running in the privileged domain, in DOM0. So the management of all of the devices has to involve the execution of the drivers that are part of DOM0. Given that VMware and its hypervisors were first to market, VMware still owns the largest percentage of virtualized server cores. So the server cores run the ESX hypervisor. Given this fact, VMware is in a position to actually mandate from the vendors that they do provide the drivers for the different devices that are going to be part of the hypervisor. Now, this is not as bad because this is really targeting the server part of the market space, and in servers, in data centers, there are not going to be that many devices, or they're going to be relatively fewer devices compared to what you would see on your laptop or desktops or in general the client platforms. To support a third-party community of developers, VMware actually also exports a number of APIs. So this is not just for the sake of the developers, but also for users when they want to configure exactly the kinds of policies that will be enforced by the hypervisor. And in the past, the ESX architecture was such that there was a control core, a control domain, if you will, that was based on a regular operating system, that was based on Linux. But right now, all of the configuration-related tasks are configured via remote APIs.